Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, thank you, sir. Today, we had the opportunity to listen to the address given by the newly elected president after he took oath in the central hall of the parliament. In fact, the newly elected president referred to those people empowering the new India, building the nation. Sir, I would like to remind the House, I would like to refer to one former president at this point of time. The former president is none other than Mr. K.R. Narayan. He made a speech, he addressed the nation, in fact, on the eve of the Republic Day, 25th January 2000. I quote what Mr. K.R. Narayan has said. On three-way first lane of liberalization, privatization, and globalization, we must provide safe pedestrian crossings for the unempowered India so that it too can move forward. Equality of status and opportunity. Beware of the fury of the passionate man, says the old adage. One could say, beware of the fury of the patient and long-suffering people. I understand what Mr. K.R. Narayan referred to patient and long-suffering people. They are the Indian farmers. They are the Indian kisans. And the whole country is witnessing the fury of those patient, long-suffering kisans of this country. That is why my party also, along with other parties, has been organizing countrywide protests. Thousands of people have been picketing and quoting arrest yesterday, today, and it will happen tomorrow also. But, sir, agrarian crisis is real. Let us admit, agrarian crisis is real. It is acute also. And while even one farmer committing suicide out of indebtedness or from lack of remunerative prices, it should sadden us. It should be unacceptable to everyone, unacceptable to you, unacceptable to me and everyone. It should sadden us. And the high number of suicides officially admitted speak for themselves. So how are we going to address these issues? It is a fact, agriculture output has been volatile. 86% of holdings are less than 2 hectares. Informal sources of credit constitute 40% of loans. These are all data available in public domain. What are the key issues? We must have long-term approach. We should have short-term approach. The short-term approach, because the farmers are passing through unprecedented distress and they must be saved, they must be rescued, for which I think the government should seriously think of loan waiver, interest waiver. Yeah. Several states have done it. Yeah. And why can't center take initiative? That is what I am asking. What is the role of the central government, union government? And there is a demand, you constitute a debt relief commission. Can you think of constituting a debt relief commission? Yeah, it is there in states like Kerala. Can you think of constituting a debt relief commission. We will have to address certain key issues, sir. What are the key issues which we confront today? One, there is increasingly decline of cultivable agricultural land for various reasons. Continuous dependence on monsoon, whether monsoon will be all right or monsoon will fail. Then inadequate access to irrigation, imbalanced use of soil nutrients, uneven access to modern technology, lack of access to formal agricultural credit, limited procurement of food grains by government agencies, and failure to provide remunerative price to the farmers. These are key issues. How we can address, as a nation, as a government, as a parliament, how we can address these key issues? That is where government will have to apply its mind. Government will have to apply its mind. How can he ensure remunerative price? And Swaminathan Commission, he was our esteemed colleague. We all know Mr. Swaminathan. Everybody refers to Swaminathan Commission report. What about Ramesh Chand committee report, which has been constituted for MSP fixing methodology? MSP fixing methodology. They have given certain equation how it should be C2 plus 50%. It is there. Why are you not implementing that? This is what I am asking. If we are concerned with the farmers, why can't we think of implementing the very committees which you constitute, government constitutes? I am not asking anything else, anything beyond that. You constituted a commission. Why did you constitute that commission? What is the purpose of constituting such commissions? They give reports, and reports are kept in cold storage, and farmers are dying. Farmers are committing suicide, and we are crying here on the floor of the parliament. And parliament, if you think parliament is supreme, I am asking you, in the name of parliament, why can't you implement those recommendations and ensure remunerative price for the farmers? On one side, you allow the cost of inputs to go up because they are all agribusiness corporations. So you support the agribusiness corporations, let them increase the price of fertilizer, let them increase the price of seeds, let them increase the price of everything. But farmers cannot get remunerative price. Then farmers go to private money lenders, farmers go to other lending agencies. Finally, what happened? And my good friend Ram Gopal Yadav was referring to Pandit Nehru. Anything can wait, not agriculture. But I refer to the other economists who said Indian farmers are born in debt. Indian farmers live in debt. Indian farmers die in debt. Is it what we want? They are the people who produce food for the whole nation. Why did we pass this Food Security Act 2013, sir? I am asking you. Why did we pass that? Because we want food security for our citizens. And this food security is given by farmers. For instance, the Food and Agricultural Organization, FAO, of the United Nations defines food security as a situation where all people have at all times physical and economic access to sufficient, safe and nutritious food that meets the dietary needs and food preferences for a healthy and active life. This is the FAO of United Nations. Sir, as members of parliament, we may belong to different parties, but we should think of our people. Our people should have decent living. Our people should have food, and our people should not starve. Yes. And here in this case, the very food producers, they are dying, sir. How can we tolerate this, sir? That is why I am pleading with you. And there are several other issues You are talking about, I am concluding, we are talking about doubling the income. And is there any farmers' income commission in this country? How can you ensure doubling the income of the farmers? And how can you ensure providing pension to the farmers? And there are problems, sir. And one more issue, serious issue. We are having water problem.
Yes.
It has become a precious one, water problem. And I know there are several river water disputes. And there are several tribunals. And whatever tribunals gave awards in the past, they are not being implemented. Kaveri board is not constituted. Sir, now the problem is these interstate river disputes must be settled. And it, time has come, we should think of interlinking rivers also. That will help us to improve our agriculture. Sir, I will conclude. In Tamil Nadu, I take the example of Tamil Nadu, it must apply to other states also. The size of the cultivable land is declining. In Tamil Nadu, for instance, the Gale pipeline, and it goes through the entire western part of Tamil Nadu. And the farmers are saying, you have it along with the national highways. Don't take it through cultivable lands. And it will affect the cultivable land. And Gale public sector undertaking, government not listening. The other thing, now Neduvasal. Tamil Nadu farmers are fighting against hydrocarbon project. Whether that project, what is the, how it was conceived, nobody knows. And people have serious doubt. It will suck away all the groundwater. It will destroy the agriculture. And there is a demand that Tanjavur, Tiruchirappalli, that belt, Tiruvarur, Nagapattinam, should be declared as an agricultural,
yes,
exclusive agricultural zone. What I am trying to say, not only Tamil Nadu, I am speaking for the whole country. No, Tamil Nadu also, I am speaking for the whole country. I speak for Punjab, I speak for Haryana, I speak for Maharashtra. When a farmer commits suicide in Marathwada, I feel my heart bleeds, I shed tears. Why my Marathi farmer should commit suicide?
Yes,
Vidarbha
Mr. Raja,
farmer
please.
Should commit suicide. Or Kannada, when Kannada, Karnataka farmer commits suicide, I feel sad. Why our people should die like that? And Orissa, if farmers pass through such distress, I feel sad. Why? Why? We have the rivers, perennial rivers, or ordinary rivers, and what else we don't have in this country? And we have such a blessed nature. We have such a land. We have working people, toiling people, very energetic people who are building the nation. Finally, when it comes to life, what life they have, the farmers' life, I am agricultural workers who depend, whose life depends upon agriculture. What is their living condition, sir? Go to any village, look at the living condition of agricultural worker. How can we sleep peacefully?
Yes, yes, you
have
conveyed already.
Peacefully? So, sir, my humble request
is the
government should address these issues with a sense of urgency.
Thank you.
With all seriousness. And government should take short-term, long-term measures to save agriculture, to save the farmers, agricultural workers, and to save India.
Thank you, Mr. Raja. Dr.